Hi everyone. So next in this class we'll discuss about applications of DC generators. We know in the classification we come to know there are majorly two types of generators, that is self separately excited DC generators and self excited DC generators. In the self-excited DC generator, again classified into three categories. One is shunt generator, the second one is series generator, and third one is compound generator. Here, the applications of the separately excited DC generators, we know that in the classification, we've seen that for operation of separately excited DC generator, that is for generation of voltage and separately excited DC generator, it requires, for field excitation, it requires a separate DC source for its excitation. So because of this requirement, this separately excited DC generator is rarely used in electric applications. Majorly, this is preferred in the application where we need to control field current independently without disturbing armature current. In that applications only we can prefer. In this case, the major applications of this separately excited DC generators is electroplating and electro refining of materials. Generally, we are going to prefer to use separately excited DC generators. Now coming to self excited DC generators, we have three classifications: shunt generators, series generator, and compound generators. We discussed already that in case of shunt generators, the amount of magnetic flux in the field winding of shunt generator is constant irrespective of load on it. Therefore, if the motor armature winding is rotated at constant speed, then irrespective of load on the generator, it generates constant voltage, because the field generates constant amount of flux, because the field in the field winding there is a constant amount of current which is given by V by RSH. So therefore, if V is constant, automatically the current in the field winding is constant, the flux is constant. Therefore, irrespective of the load on the generator, it generates constant voltage. Because of its nature, its characteristics, it is mainly used for battery charging purpose, because for battery charging it requires constant voltage. So for that purpose we are going to prefer battery charging. And similarly for lightning also, ordinary lightning purpose also, we can prefer constant voltage. Therefore, we are going to prefer to use this shunt generator in two applications majorly, that is battery charging and ordinary lightning purpose. Next generator is series generator. We know that in case of series generator, the amount of field current is flowing is same as load current. Therefore, if there is no load on the generator, means the amount of current flowing in the field winding is zero almost. So EMF induced in the series generator is due to only residual flux. Therefore, the amount of flux is very very small. Therefore, voltage induced and no load condition is nearly 10 to 15% of rated voltage. But as the load on the generator is increased, then the current flowing in the field winding is increased. Therefore, flux is increased. Therefore, thereby the voltage induced in a DC series generator is increased. So it is rated value of generator only when there is a rated load on the generator. So depending upon the load on the generator, the amount of voltage generated in the series generator depends. So because of its nature, so depending upon its characteristics, so majorly this series generator is used for booster in for DC feeders. We know the feeder booster means at very heavy loading conditions. So there is a huge amount of voltage drop taking place in the transmission lines or distribution lines. So in that case, to boost up the voltage in the distribution lines, we are going to use a series generator as booster, that is to increase the voltage magnet in the feeders. We are going to prefer to use series generator. And second one is, irrespective of amount of voltage generated in this, it supplies constant current to the load. That's why it is also used as constant current generator. So these are the two applications of DC generator. One is used for booster application because of its characteristics and constant current generator. The third one is compound generator. Compound generator. So in the compound generator, so again it is classified into based on the flux produced in the series field winding as well as shunt field winding. If both series field winding and shunt field both are in additive nature, that is flux produced in series field winding as well as shunt field winding is added to together, then it is called as cumulatively compound generator. If the flux produced in series generator and series field winding and compound shunt field winding is opposite in nature, then that if both the flux are in opposite directions, then that generator is called as differentially compound generator. In cumulatively compound generator, the major application is it generates a rated voltage with a slight variation of voltage magnitudes. That's why this cumulatively compound generator majorly used in domestic lightning applications. And second one is differentially compound generator, that is series field flux and shunt field flux both are in opposite directions. That's why it is called differentially compound generator. This generator basically used for electric arc welding, that is it supplies constant current for its welding applications. Therefore, because of its nature, it can used for electric arc welding. The differentially compound generator used in electric arc welding. So these are the various applications of DC generators. Thank you.